local, late breaking. This is WBAL-TV 11 News at Noon in HD.
I felt the building shake, and I thought it was just my imagination, but then my wife came running out the bedroom, and she said, oh my God, I think we're having an earthquake.
A rude awakening for much of Maryland as an earthquake rocks Montgomery County. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mindy Becerra. That earthquake is our big story this noon. The 3.6 magnitude quake was centered in the Rockville area. We're hearing reports it was felt as far north as Upperco. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey is live in our newsroom with more for us. Kim, it wasn't exactly the big one, but it caught a lot of people off guard.
Well, it certainly did, Mindy. The good news is there are no reports of major damage or any injuries. And in case you slept through it, the quake hit at 5:04 this morning while a lot of people were still in bed or getting ready for work. And while a 3.6 magnitude quake is considered minor, the U.S. Geological Survey's National Earthquake Information Center says this was the strongest earthquake to hit the Washington, D.C. area since they began taking records in 1974. Early commuters certainly felt it.
I was in the subway and I felt a rumbling overhead, and I was thinking, okay, the trains don't run overhead. The trains run, you know, on the platform where I was standing. And I was kind of puzzled, but I didn't think it was an earthquake.
Our phones lit up seconds after the quake, and 11 News viewers from all over Central Maryland share their experiences on WBALTV.com and on our Facebook page. Heather writes, I live in Eldersburg. I felt my whole house shaking and there was a loud sound. Laura from Catonsville says the quake, quote, woke me up, rattling dishes and pictures on the wall. And Lynn in Brooklyn Park says the earthquake, quote, shook us for around 10 to 15 seconds. I thought, what in the world kind of plane was taking off at the airport to shake us like that? Then quickly realized that was no plane. Governor Martin O'Malley says although the quake was minor, state crews are out looking for damage.
We've identified no serious structural damage, but we are doing a number of things. Of course, we checked in with Calvert Cliffs, and Calvert Cliffs appears to be fine, and they're, you know, reviewing all of their structures as well. We are sending inspectors out to bridges, especially the most heavily traveled bridges around the Washington 495 Beltway, American Legion Bridge, Northwest Branch, and others to check on them. We are also working in tandem with our county officials and just keeping an eye on things to and anticipate that there probably will be some rupture underground of some pipe somewhere that might not be evident yet, but could break under the pressure as time goes on.
Now again, Mindy, no reports of any major damage or injuries in this earthquake, but geologists say we should be on the lookout for multiple aftershocks in the coming hours and days. We've actually already experienced the first aftershock less than an hour ago. That quake registered as a 2.0. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kim Dacey, WBAL TV 11 News.
All right, thank you, Kim. We posted an interactive guide to earthquakes, and you can test your trivia and our earthquake quiz on WBALTV.com. It's at the top of the homepage.